Hey guys, it's so good to talk to you again. I'm so glad that you've joined me in this video. Today, I just wanted to give you an update on my life, and you guys have asked a lot of questions on Instagram regarding so many things about my life, my take on a certain topic and so on. So today I just want to talk to you guys, answer some questions that you guys asked me, and catch up with you. So if you want to know more, just keep watching. So the first question you guys asked me is what I'm doing now. So a lot of you know that I just graduated last year by doing my master's. So I finished all my studies, I finished school, college, and also my post-graduation. So I'm really relieved that that part of my life is over. But I'm still learning a lot more things along the way in this journey called life. And also I'm working on my music. So last year I released my first original English album. I wrote all the songs myself. I collaborated with a lot of artists, a lot of musicians to come up with a lot of the songs. So that's what you guys heard in the album journey. So next I wanted to work on my Tamil album with Tamil songs. Mostly it'll be made up of covers, songs by other people that I take and reimagine it in a new way, in a modern way, and also writing original songs that you guys can enjoy. So I already have an original out, Velicham Theri, that was done a long time ago. So I want to give you guys Tamil songs as well that you can jam out to and worship God with. And also I'm working on writing new blogs. So a lot of spiritual topics that I can share my thoughts on, as well as making blogs for this channel. So that's what is on my list as of now. That's what I will be working on and bringing out. A lot of you have been giving me positive responses on my album, and I've been releasing music videos for them in my music channel. So if you haven't already checked it out, you can check it out to know what I'm doing. Just to stay tuned with me in this channel, my music channel, also on my website, and you will get to know more about my work. So the next question is, I used to listen to secular music regularly. It affected my spirituality. How does it not affect you? So my take on this is music is just a form of storytelling. Just like how we watch a movie, we read a book, we listen to people's stories by having conversations with them. Music is just another way to express those thoughts, those feelings, those emotions, and those experiences. Obviously, some songs have explicit things, a lot of things that they mention or sing about that we don't relate to, or things that we might not agree with, or it doesn't align with our beliefs and our values. So those things we don't have to listen to. We can choose not to listen to those songs if we think that it affects our spirituality, if it affects our relationship with God. Personally, I love listening to songs that inspire me, comfort me, and it just simply puts me in a good mood. So I love listening to genres that I really like, and also I look for lyrics that are really unique, really captivating, or just simply music elements that I'm attracted to. So I listen to songs like that so that I can take my favorite parts of that song and use it in my music as well. So it all depends on the intention of the song and what you take from it. Someone asked, any tips for a new blogger? What I would say is create things that you are passionate about. Many people relate to what you are excited about, and they can tell how much effort you put into it if you put in a little effort, or if you put in a lot of effort when creating something. So go crazy, go wild, and create content that you enjoy making, and make sure that it brings glory to God's name when you make it. Someone asked, how to meditate the Bible in an easy way? How to take notes during my personal Bible study? So what I would say, in my personal life, I follow this reading plan. So when I open up my Bible, I either focus on either two or three sections for that day, or two or three pages, and so on. So I have this reading plan that I have for the day. I read the sections, and whatever verses pop out to me, I write them in a book, and I also write down what I can take from it, what I can learn from it, what I can apply in my life during that situation. And that makes me remember those verses a lot more, and I can like go back to it whenever I need more encouragement. And also I take those verses and I remind myself of those verses for the whole day and pray over them so that it encourages me, uplifts me, and gives me strength for the whole day. I talk about this in a more detailed way in another video called How I Study the Bible, so you can check that out. It'll definitely be helpful for you during your Bible study time, your personal devotional time, and you can learn more about ways that you can incorporate those little details. Another question is, would you be a worship leader if it wasn't for your famous grandfather? So I make music because I made a commitment when I accepted Jesus as my personal savior that whatever I do, it'll be for the glory of God. So at that time, I was singing songs, I was posting on social media. I used to sing songs in prayer meetings, and that's how it progressed and progressed, and I started leading worship in prayer meetings, and also started writing blogs, doing videos, and so on. So that's how I developed this passion of mine. And my intention is that since I have a platform because of my famous grandparents and parents, I use that platform to the best of my ability. So I sing in prayer meetings, I sing, I lead worship, I write blogs, and do all of these things because I have a platform and I can share Jesus in a larger scale. Yes, I could have picked another career or anything, but this is what I wanted to do because I had a passion to share my experiences, share whatever I can from my personal life to people who relate to me, people who are in my age group, so that they can benefit off of it and grow their relationship with Christ. So even if I didn't have famous grandparents or parents, I would have still be doing all the things that I'm doing behind the scenes now, which is maybe content creating, editing a video, or social media promotion, promoting music, and so on. So I would still be doing all of those things for the glory of God. Someone asked, what is it like to be so popular? So ever since I was young, since I grew up in a famous family, I had everything I ever wanted without even lifting a finger. There were people to serve me. I didn't have to do anything, literally, from taking my laundry to washing it to folding it to putting it in my cupboard. I had people to do everything for me. So from living that kind of a lifestyle, I was literally plucked from that place, and I was placed in a place where people didn't even know who I was. I had to learn to do everything myself, from washing the dishes, to mowing the lawn, to shoveling the snow from the driveway, to walking to school 20 minutes in knee-deep worth of snow, wearing all those boots and everything, covering myself up from the wind, and also taking the bus to go grocery shopping, taking all of those groceries back in a basket, walking home, and also when we would go to prayer meetings, we just started those prayer meetings weekly in that place, and so it was so new for everybody. And apart from my family members, there were only like two people who would attend the prayer meetings. So that's how much of a difference that I had to face from the thousands that would come to our prayer meetings in India, and the people everywhere, wherever I went, there were people to serve me, to help me, to do everything for me. And coming back to this place to live this kind of a lifestyle, it was so different for me. And I had to learn so much, so many new things. And through those experiences, God taught me patience. God taught me to take care of myself, and also to be grateful for all the people that he had provided in my life to pray for me, to help me, and to support me. And for each and every person who would show up to listen to the gospel that we would share. Now I'm able to appreciate all the people that would help me, every single person who would come to the prayer meetings, the thousands that would gather, and speak to them just as how I would speak to a person in front of me, like an individual, and have a one-on-one conversation with them, and also be confident that I don't need anybody else in this world except trusting in God. So God had led me through all those experiences and gave me this confidence, gave me and taught me so many lessons. So I'm sure that if I was here, I would have been living like a brat, enjoying everything that I had. But God had made me go through that experience and taught me so many things that shaped me into who I am now. So if I was seeking fame or money or power, then obviously I would have gone in a different direction and I would have had everything I wanted and more. People are still saying that that's the case, even if it weren't true. But then now I'm doing everything that I can, every song that I make, every writing that I do, every video that I post, it's all for the glory of God, to just to share one simple story from my life, one simple experience from my life. I just wanted to share that through all of these platforms. Young people are just drawn to listen to the word of God, and that's truly what I care about in life. Obviously, there might be mistakes that I make, and also I'm learning each day as every person would, but I'm open enough to share it with you guys, and we are all in this journey together and living the lifestyle of a follower of Christ. So today you might have come to this video to hate on me or to share this video to someone just to talk bad about me, but then it only makes the gospel reach more and more people, because without God, I am nothing. Jesus is getting more and more popular and more famous through me. So someone asked, what's the best advice for teenagers? Well, Lord, everything I do is for your name. That's the answer. Is it easy to overcome temptations of the world being an evangelist's kid? We're also people just like you. We go through the same temptations, distractions, if not more. We also face a lot of discouragement in our journey, but we don't get to share it with anybody because we are supposed to hold up this persona of being holy, of being righteous, and nothing should go wrong in our lives. We don't face any bad things, or else they would think, oh, God is not with them, they are doing something wrong. They have all of these assumptions about us, but in the end, we're just people just like you, and we go through a lot of things in our lives as well. God is my only outlet to talk about this, because I can't go to anybody because of the feeling of being judged. So because of that, I pour out my heart to him even from a young age, from right when I accepted God as my savior. I started pouring out my heart to him of all the hate that I would get, the discouragement that I would face, all the temptations I would get, or even weaknesses that I might face in my life. I just shared out to God, and from that moment on, I could feel that God was guiding me. God was raising me up as a child. So I couldn't tell my parents about it because they were also facing a lot of things in their life. They would be traveling a lot, being busy. My siblings would be facing their own problems. So I wasn't able to share it with anybody except God. And he raised me as his child and taught me everything that I needed to know, gave me knowledge. Yes, that's how God raised me, just like it says in Psalm 32:8. It says, I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. So that's exactly what God did in my life. And that's what I'm able to do. Share all those experiences with you through my music, through my blogs, and through my vlogs and my videos on social media. So I'm glad you are on this journey with me, and you get to learn a lot. You get to go through certain life experiences with me, and also grow more in your relationship with God. So that's the end goal, and that's all I'm trying to do for you guys and help you with. So my heart is that you will grow closer to God in your life as well. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned a lot about me and my perspective on a lot of things. And I hope to see you guys and connect with you on social media. If you're not getting my post, don't forget to click the notifications button and follow my posts so that you're updated on everything that I do. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, and also comment below your thoughts, and also subscribe to this channel and hit that bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video. Till I see you next time. Bye.